Tom Woods and Stefan Molyneux did a podcast recently, and look, I can't be bothered to give a shit. I really don't care when Molyneux's on other people's shows or vice versa. As much of a critic as I am of Molyneux, I really don't care. I usually just skip those episodes. And I love Tom Wood's show, but every time Molyneux's on, I just skip the episodes. And there's so many different episodes for me to choose from. And not just that, but Contra Krugman and as well. There's just so much content that Tom Woods produces that I'm behind on, and two, that I could choose from that I don't need to suffer through Molyneux. Because Molyneux, at the end of the day, is a hack fraud when it comes to philosophy. He doesn't know what the fuck he's talking about in philosophy, yet he thinks that he's the second coming of Socrates. And I'm not being hyperbolic. He said statements to that effect. But anyway, but there's real criticisms about Molyneux that he doesn't address, and instead kind of brings up stuff from the more kind of left crazy shit that, you know, the left side of the libertarian sphere is kind of always brings up and stuff, which may or may not be valid. I'm not going to get into that in this video. What I really want to do at first, before I get into the really deep criticisms of Molyneux, I just want to substantiate something that I said earlier when I said Molyneux is a hack fraud. So about the 5 minute mark, Tom Woods says people who criticize him, Tom Woods, of being on Molyneux's show or vice versa are losers because they haven't done anything for liberty. Basically, he said that, you know, they're losers and they haven't done anything like me because I've created a K-12 program for homeschoolers. What the fuck have you ever done? Nothing. Well, first of all, it doesn't necessarily follow. They could be doing things behind the scenes. They could be doing subversive things behind the scenes. For all you know, they could be the creator of Bitcoin, who is still at this point completely anonymous. They could have done a number of things. You don't know that. Secondly, it doesn't matter. If you were to bring up this argument to Molyneux about his fans and as a reason why he's wrong about something, there's three words that he would utter, and I probably don't even have to say them because I'm sure it's so ingrained as a Molyneux meme at this point. I guess I'll say it anyway. He'd say that's not an argument, and it would be right. Like, who cares if they're losers? Are they wrong because they're losers? No, it doesn't necessarily mean they're wrong. Now, I may be, like I said, I really don't care if Tom has him on his show. I think that people who are freaking out and think that you should deplatform anyone who's kind of guilty of talking about topics that are taboo, I think that's a little bit beyond the pale. I think there's other good reasons not to be involved with Molyneux, which we will get into. But yeah, but basically at the end of the day, this is just a retread version of, you know, what have you ever done for liberty, bro? And I'm going to explain why it's relevant, why it's a fucking terrible argument. Besides the fact that it's a completely fallacious line of reasoning, is that when you're on a public forum, especially on a big show like Molyneux, and you say something completely stupid, completely irrational, like what have you ever done for liberty, as an argument against someone's claims, whether or not they're valid or not doesn't matter. If you're using that as an argument against somebody, you're kind of disrupting anything that you've ever done and kind of calling into question anything that you've ever done right off the bat. Look, I've been asked by Larkin Rose and Rich Paul, who have done some good activism or have contributed things to libertarianism, both good and bad. I'm not going to get into that here. I've been asked by them, like, what have you ever done for liberty? And my answer has always been the same for anyone who has ever asked me this question, more than you have. Because if you're on a public platform and you ask something that fucking retarded, it really calls into question anything that you've ever done for liberty. You know, like, why should I even pay attention to anything that you've ever done because you said something this stupid? And it falls in line with the same kind of reasoning that it would take for someone to make that argument in the first place. Like, well, you're a loser. Why should I take your criticism seriously? You can't have it both ways. You can't say, well, one is fallacious and the other one's not. No, they're both fallacious. And I'm sorry, but that's just the way it is. But I've never made this criticism about Tom Woods, but I'm sure that it's someone who has made criticism of Tom Woods, who he's using this argument on, could probably reverse it in that way, and I highly would advise that you do so. But here's my Molyneux. Here's my problem with Molyneux, Tom, if you're listening, which I don't know if you would be. Molyneux has convinced swaths of young children and teenagers and young adults to completely cut off ties from their loved ones, such for the terrible child abusive actions such as sending their kids to Sunday school. Because, as you know, as a good Catholic, Tom, telling your kids about hell is psychological abuse, and telling them fanciful tales about hell to keep them moral and to get them to do certain things that you want them to do by threatening them with eternal damnation, well, that's psychologically scarring, and you should definitely defue anybody who ever does that to you as growing up, including your friends and loved ones. Now, Molyneux, and you guys talked about a little bit about changing your mind, which fine, like I have no problem with Molyneux changing his mind, but here's the problem. Molyneux has changed his mind about Christianity. I don't know if he's changed his mind about sending your kid to Sunday school being child abuse, but did he ever issue an apology for all the people who did do that under his guidance? Did he ever encourage his fans to say, like, hey, I made this bad mistake, I made this poor reasoning, if anybody followed my advisement to deassociate from your family of origin for the heinous crime of being sent to Sunday school, maybe you should reconnect with some of your family members because I was wrong? Nope, never did that. Never. And he probably won't either. And I'm sure if you bring up this criticism of Molyneux, he probably won't have you on your show again. But either way, the other one that I'm a bit worried about, because I don't know how you didn't catch this one, the DMCA drama where he used the threat of government violence against YouTube to silence one of his major critics. And I'm not going to get into the details of this. I'll link a video in the description below, which I talk about his almost banning from YouTube, where I actually get into the story about what happened with Molyneux and the DMCA. You can go and watch that. I've done that topic to death. But I'm curious, because normally when libertarians criticize Molyneux, one of the first things that get brought up is the DMCA thing. And I'm not really surprised, but I'm pretending to be surprised for this video. I'm really surprised that you didn't bring that one up, Tom. Why didn't you bring that one up? Look, you can go ahead and keep talking to Molyneux. I don't care. I'll just skip those episodes. Your other episodes are so good that, you know, I'm willing to ignore it and turn the other cheek. I'm not even criticizing you for having him on. You can do that as much as you want. But please, stop pretending like you have addressed any of the really major concerns that libertarians have with Molyneux, because he didn't. He just didn't. Anyways, I will talk to you guys later. Hail Satan.